am the first spirit and gatekeeper of Hades. I will never leave this broken land. However, now that light and darkness have disappeared, I must go back to my eternal sleep. I will wake up one last time when all life has disappeared from this land. Well, then the sleep's not eternal. I wish the day will never come. Alright, maybe it will be eternal. ML says, Durga, thank you. Alright, now we gotta get out of this friggin' place. Thank you for protecting me with your motherly love. Gawain says, Durga is now in an eternal sleep. I can't hear you. We must walk on our feet without the help of the gods. Avon says, Belius also said that a disaster that would shake the world was going to befall upon us in the near future. Do you think we can really solve the problem by ourselves? Ruti says, Don't worry, Avon. Durga told us, remember? We can bring a miracle if we join together in love. Miles says, Look, I'm alive again. Hum. That's right, says Avon. Lucius says, If something does happen, all of us will work together and the problem will be solved.
I think it's a kind of miracle that brought us together.
You're right, says Eleanor. It's possible that we would have never met. Archim says, Avon's love brought us all together. Vale says, So my presence here is a miracle, huh? Ha ha ha, I think I'm going to be a great sorcerer. Don't fall off, that thing. Yeah, he pulled him back. Douglas thinking the same thing. Don't jump around, kid. You'll fall off the cliff. I'm not kid, old man. Old man, I'm only 28. Michelle says, But we must study to find out what's at the end of Gagarv. It is likely that the disaster is brewing in the third land beside Tirasweel and Elfilden. Yes, see the next game, Song of the Ocean, or Cage Song of the Ocean, which I'll be playing next. Gawain says, I will consult Krar about it. Bardas is gone. The church will have a difficult time ahead. Muse says, The royal family will fully cooperate. My father will understand the gravity of the situation. Marty says, Of course, but not before the king gives you a stern lecture about sneaking out of the castle. Shut up! Avon laughs. You all are great, says Amel. Yeah, says Avon. I have you, and Mile, and Retis, Gawain, and everyone. We'll be able to overcome anything together. So long, Bardas. I have known you for very long, but thanks for everything. Let's go home. To our Elfilden. Priest Krar says, Light and darkness have both departed. I suspected something like this would happen after reading that passage in the scripture. However, now that the era of gods is really over, I feel uneasy. Avon says, What will happen to the Bardas Church? Well, I think I will tell the world exactly what happened. People may be confused, but that is the final test of gods. Until everyone stands on their own feet, the Bardas Church will remain here. Yu says, The royal family fully supports the church's position.
As the Lord of Beloa, I will do my best to ensure that my people understand.
Douglas says, I'll talk to my fellow adventurers from the guild. We may have tough times ahead, but the future is worth fighting for. Eleanor says, I'll go back to the sorcery school and study the Blue Tribe civilization, so we won't make the same mistake again. Michelle, please help me.
My pleasure, Professor Eleanor. The system of sorcery of Elfilden is complex. I've always wanted to go to the sorcery school. Unfortunately, I have a previous engagement. Can I help you after I finish it?
Eleanor says, Of course. I'll be waiting for you.
Just get to her before you turn into Grandpa Lap.
Avon says, Michelle, what's your previous engagement? Are you going home?
I promised Thomas that I would help him cross Gagarv with the Planetos. I think Thomas is planning to modify the Planetos to make it faster and more sturdy.
Can he do that? Avon says, That's Gawain's ship.
Gawain says, I decided to give the Planetos to Thomas. He'll become a better sailor than I ever was. Besides, studying the other side of the Gagarv is very important to ensure there is peace in Elfilden.
Thomas will find out everything he can for us. The revelation Lord Belius received on Truth Island, if it's true, then it's a matter of grave concern.
Marty says we must learn about the whole world instead of being confined in the small area of Elfilden. We're going to be very busy. The priest says the times are changing. We all must work together, or harder.
Harder together?
Both. However, we humans need some rest. Everyone go back to your hometown and recover your energy. Gawain says, the Planetos will arrive at Brazak tomorrow and will take you to the eastern continent. For tonight, however, please stay at this grand cathedral. ML says, Avon, what are we going to do now?
Well,
we'll be leaving tomorrow, so maybe we should walk around to see the town of Valkt.
I don't want to check in on everybody again. I've done that too many times.
Miles says, come to think of it, Emel and I never had the chance to relax in the Holy Capital. Will you show us around the town?
All right then, says Avon.
Rutice, you're coming too, right?
Well, I...
Mile! Girl's voice. It's... What's her name? What's her name again? Stephanie or something? Shannon. That was close. Starts with an S.
Mile! Oh, Mile! I knew it! I knew you would come back for me!
Shannon, he says. You look, lively, as always.
The energy has returned to me now that you've returned. I'm very, very happy. You're safe and well.
Shannon, I'm sorry I made you worry, but could you please not hug me so tightly?
You're choking me. I can't breathe.
Ah ha ha ha. That's the least you can do for her, Avon says. Shannon was really worried about you. Emel chuckles.
Hi, Shannon. I'm Emel, Avon's sister.
Yes, I saw you in Beloa. Avon and Mile told me all about you, says Emel. About how lively and cute you were.
Really? They said I was cute? How embarrassing.
Avon says, Hey, Shannon, we're going to walk around in the town. Would you like to join us?
That's great. I can walk hand in hand with Mile. I'd love to come.
Mile says, Who said anything about walking hand in hand? Well, I guess it's okay.
Rutice says, I'm sorry, but I can't go. I have something to think about.
What is it? Says Avon.
I'll tell you later.
Hey, Rutice. Shannon says, What's wrong with Rutice? She looked a little sad. Amel says, Avon, shouldn't you go after Rutice?
Why should I?
Miles says, It's a man's job to ask his lady what's wrong and to help her out, you know?
Emel says, You are not good at this, my brother.
Take it easy on me, will you? When did she become his lady? I was waiting for him to ask that. Avon says, Ah, there you are. Avon, weren't you supposed to show them around?
Well,
you seem kind of down, so everyone told me to come and check on you.
Oh, okay.
She wants it to be his thought, not them to be telling him that.
I'm sorry I made everyone worry.
Don't worry about it, says Avon. Avon says, By the way, we'll all board the Planetos tomorrow to go back to the eastern continent. You're going back to Ruka's, right?
I'll miss you. We've been traveling together for quite some time now.
That's right, says Rutice.
Hey, tell me what's wrong.
If something is bothering you, I want to know.
Avon, I...
Tomorrow. Avon and the others will board the Planetos and head for their home on the eastern continent.
You're cutting it off now?
Avon, I... And then she's supposed to finish saying it. She's gonna say that she loves him or something. Figured that was coming, but... Did she ever say it? Was it, like, off-screen, quote-unquote? Huh? Oh, we're flashing back now. Ruti says, I've been thinking a lot about what will happen to Octum's apostles. Master Belius, Borgide, Bernard, they're dead now, but they all had darkness within them. Just like I used to. They couldn't find the light they were longing for, and ended up hating it. Those poor people. The other apostles are probably the same. I see, says Avon. But they're only human. If I had lost a Mel and Mile, I might have been drawn to the darkness of Octum, too. Ruti says, no, not you. You have a strong mind. But everyone else has some weakness inside. Darkness sneaks into us through small cracks. Actually, that darkness is not Octum. It's our alter ego. It's very difficult to accept who we really are and dispel the darkness inside us. But, Rutis, you dispelled your darkness. I think you've done a great job. Thank you. I could do it because you taught me so many things. You taught me how important it is to love yourself and others. And gave me the courage to stay on course no matter what happens. Thank you, Avon. With your help, I was able to overcome the darkness within me. I'm kind of flattered, says Avon. Actually, I didn't do anything. I owe you too, you know. I couldn't have come this far without you. Without you, I would have been killed by Octum's apostles and wouldn't have been able to rescue Mile and Mel. Thanks, Ruti's. I sincerely appreciate what you've done for me. Says Ruti's. Awkward silence, I guess. More awkward silence. Ha, says Avon. Heh, heh, says Ruti's. This isn't like us, says Avon. We can be like this now and then, Ruti's says. Say, Ruti's, after you go back to Ruka's, why don't both of you come to the lookout cottage? It's bigger than it looks, and we have plenty of room for two guests. Ruti's? Avon, I'm not going back to Ruka's, just yet. What? My journey isn't over yet. What are you saying? Says Avon. I thought you already made up your mind. Yes, I did. But I still have a duty to fulfill. A duty to fulfill? The Octum's apostles are not gone yet. Many remaining members are still causing problems in Southern Deucis, refusing to believe that Master Belius is dead. I need to convince them of the truth. But... You've done more than enough, Ruti's. Why do you have to sacrifice yourself more? I was able to catch the light and dispel my darkness, she says. I was with Master Belius when he died. I'm the only one who will be able to convince them. It's my duty. Or maybe it's not a duty. I want to tell the other apostles, who still have darkness in them, about the potential they have inside them. I'm doing this because I feel that it's my duty and responsibility. Archim is home. All right then, says Avon. I'll come with you. I owe you for all the help you've given me along the way. It's my turn to help you. Ruti smiles. I knew you were going to say that. But you have a Mel and Mile now. Go home with them. That will be the end of your journey. But I can't leave you alone. You won't be able to help me, says Ruti's. You are a very strong person. You have this burning passion and love in you. That's your Tear of Vermillion, See, now they spell it with two L's. Those who are still trapped in darkness will see your glowing strength as a target of envy, jealousy, and hatred. That's why I don't want you to come. But... That's Amel at the sorcery school, I'm guessing? Well, it's not Amel. Amel is a red-haired one. I'm sorry, Avon, says Retis. Here you are, offering to help me out of the kindness in your heart, and I'm saying all these cruel things to you. But I have to be strong myself. I want to stand on my own feet and protect others. Only then can I face you and Ruka with confidence. Until then, I can't take advantage of your friendship. Avon says, I'm not saying this out of friendship or kindness. I want to do something for you, Retis. Because I... Stop, says Retis. Please, Avon. Don't say any more. Retis. Just say it, Avon. Just say it. Small town. Oh yeah, that's where Shannon... That's Shannon's house. Ah, she's dragging him in the house! Thank you, says Retis. You almost made me cry. Whatever feelings you have for me, they're mutual. Avon says, then why? If I hear the words, I'll be tempted to depend on you. If I do, then I can't be strong. So please, please don't say anything. Okay, I'll wait. What? I'll be worried about you, but I'll wait for you to complete your journey. When you're done, come to the lookout cottage. After going back to Ruka's, promise me you will come visit me. I'll finish my sentence then. Back at, what's it called, the starting town? Miles' hometown? I like how we have these scenes without words and then the others with all dialogue. It's pretty interesting. Wait for me, but it's going to be a dangerous journey. I don't know if I'll even survive it. Avon says, always think about your safety first. I know you'll overcome any ordeal. I don't know when I'm going to finish. Honestly, I don't know if I can wait. Avon says, I may just get up and come to you one day. But I'll try my best to stay put. So do whatever you must to your heart's content. Avon, I... Retis, just don't do anything reckless. I'm trying really hard to contain myself here. Will you promise you'll come back safe? Yes, I promise. I'll come back to you. I will. Man's grave. He did it. They got back his sister Amel. And then... Many seasons pass. The great shock of the announcement made by the Bardis Church. is this? Is that Marty? Is that Muse? He runs away whistling or something? Is that Rail? Oops, Professor Eleanor. Get back in there, Rail. Oh, the Siam Seal Gang? Wow, been a while since I've seen these guys. There are monsters to defeat. And chests to open. Bling! Bling! Maybe they're music boxes. Douglas and Lucius, I think? Oh, they're gonna have another duel? Is that their master? Their master's grave? Leaving food. Are they, like, dancing? Even though she's, like, sitting down or kneeling down? Flowers for... I forget her name. And, the blue bandana man. Madrum. I don't remember his name. There's the furnace. Making some more rare metal, perhaps? Thank you. Miles says, "It's almost time for the Harvest Festival." Avon says, "Right. It's that time of the year already. We must start preparations." ML says, "I've never been to the Harvest Festival, so I'm very excited. It's a celebration to thank Spirit Nephthys, right?" "Yeah," says Avon. "The gods may be gone and spirits asleep, but customs like this won't disappear anytime soon." Miles says, "There's no need to stop the celebrations. It's good to have a sense of appreciation. Besides, it's sad to see ceremonies like floating charms go. They become our favorite distractions." "What are floating charms?" asks ML. "It's a ceremony performed at the beginning of the Harvest Festival. We look for charms hidden in various places in the village and float them on a stream leading to Nephthys' shrine. If your charm floats to the shrine, your wish will be granted." "Sounds like fun," says ML. Avon says, "Actually, my wish was granted. It may have been the blessing of the spirit." "Right," says Mile. "So, what are you going to wish for, ML?" "Well, let's see. Happiness for everyone, maybe." "Haha, that's so like you, ML," says Avon. "That's cute," Mile says. "Don't tease me. How about you two? What are you going to wish?" "Wish," says Avon. "Well, I..." "Avon," says Mile. "What's wrong, Avon?" ML says. "Mile!" "Shannon." "I know that voice," says Avon. "It can't be," Mile says. "I don't think you're ever going to get rid of her, Mile." "Mile, it's been a long time," she says. "Wow, Shannon. "Welcome, Shannon," says ML. "You look lively as always," Avon says. "Avon, ML, nice to see you again. What brought you here today, Shannon?" says Mile. "I heard about Ort's Harvest Festival, so I came here to help." Ort is the name of the village I could remember before. "That's, good. Thank you," says Mile. "Haha, lucky you, Mile," says Avon. "We shouldn't stand outside talking. Shannon, please come inside and make yourself at home. I'll go chop some firewood." Mile says, "Avon?" ML also says, "Avon. I'll soon be too busy with the preparation for the Harvest Festival. I should do it now while I have the time." "What's wrong with Avon?" Shannon says. "He looked a little sad." Miles says, "I know why, but it's something I shouldn't meddle in." ML says, "He shouldn't wait. He should go to her." Miles says, "On one hand, Avon is quick-tempered, but on the other, he is very stubborn. I guess we'll keep waiting until she comes back." "Oh, my poor brother," says ML. "ML, are you a little jealous?" says Mile. "Teehee, only a little. But what I want to see most is his smile. Rutice cheered me up when Avon went down to Hades." "Rutice," says Shannon. "Oh, I almost forgot." "What?" says Mile. "Actually, I didn't come here alone. On my way to Ort," Shannon says. "No matter what happens, another piece of wood keeps appearing." Avon says, "Whew, maybe this is enough." Alright, I'm not clicking past this. It's just going away really quickly, so I'm gonna have to read quickly. "Were you chopping firewood?" Girl's voice says. Rutice says, "You're such a hard worker." "This is part of my training," says Avon. "I'm training myself so I can help someone who is out there traveling alone if they need it," something like that. "Rutice," says Avon. "I'm home, Avon," she says. In the era after the passing of the gods, mankind was lost in darkness. But there is a light that shines the way. A tear of vermilion that shines within the heart. Again, with two L's. However small that tear may be. Thank you. The joining of hearts will create a stream that brings a miracle.
That's it. The end. Stay tuned tomorrow for Song of the Ocean. The final Legend of Heroes game that is not a Trails game. Yep, after Song of the Ocean is complete, I'll be playing Trails in the Sky. Greatly looking forward to that. Even more so. So what did you guys think of this excellent game? I really enjoyed it. I'm not sure if I like Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch better or Tear of Vermillion. They're both pretty awesome, I think. At least we didn't have long goodbyes. Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch drive me crazy with the whole episode was just people saying goodbye to each other. I'm like, yes, go away. Bye. I greatly enjoy this. So glad. Mile lives. Oh, look at that. The Legend of Heroes Gagarv Trilogy, A Tear of Vermillion. Now that's with one L. They really can't make up their mind, can they? I love the character of Imel. Mile is awesome. Haven's awesome. Rutice! I feel like they could have developed Rutice maybe a little bit more. But Douglas was great. Professor Elanoa. Rail. Who was that kid who turned invisible? Lucius was awesome. Lucius was watching over him. Unless I'm remembering wrong, and that was Rail. I'm pretty sure it was... Was it a red-headed kid? I thought he would show up at the end. Again, still, I might have it confused. That's a very short skirt. Okay, I guess that's supposed to be Rutice. This looks like, more like the characters from the PC version, I believe. If I have that right. Although I've never played it. It's only in Japanese, I think. I'm looking for this kid. The Mifas were... I could do or not do with them. Always saying Mune and stuff. What is this guy? So, there was a lot more backtracking in this game than in Tears, in Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. Jimmy! That's his name. Jimmy, the kid who disappears. He didn't show up again. What the hell? I figured he was gonna show up at the end with his invisibility. And, like, surprise backstab enemies or something like that. Surprise them. No Jimmy. Well, I never. And Archim is adorable. Marty is pretty cool. Muse is awesome. I think as far as the amount of memorable characters, Gawain is friggin' awesome. I think Tear of Vermillion had more memorable characters. Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch had, like, a couple memorable characters. This is, like, filled with memorable characters.
but I liked how in Prophecy, there was no backtracking. You just continued touring the land. Technically, it was supposed to be The Legend of Heroes 3, and 4 was supposed to be Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. But they messed up the localization. Not only with the translation, but with the release order of the games. But in any case, we can all pretty much agree Song of the Ocean is the last one. Before Trails, that is. Because Trails in the Sky is Trails of Cold Steel, also part of the Legend of Heroes games. Sailor Thomas says, "Good, Popo. Good boy." Ruff. Kerr-coo. Michelle says, "Is it from the plant manager in Guia?" "No, it's from Ruka. They're finally starting to build the ship." "Congratulations, Thomas. You're one step closer to achieving your dream." "I appreciate your help, Professor Lapp. We were only able to come up with the required configuration of the new ship because of your knowledge of Gagarth. It'll be a high-speed vessel driven by the state-of-the-art HF2 engine. I never imagined we would need that kind of tremendous performance." Michelle says, "That's the minimum requirement for reaching the land in the south. We were lucky we could refine the large quantity of rare metal needed to build the frame of the HF2 engine." Thomas says, "For that, I really appreciate the help of Ruka and his friends. Speaking of rare metal, do you still have Avon's sword?" "Yes, here." "Lucian," Thomas says, "the sacred sword empowered by Bardas." Wow, I'm surprised Avon didn't hold on to it. "Although it no longer has its power, the sight of it still sends shivers down my spine." Michelle says, "Avon told me Elfilden no longer needs this sword. Give it to someone in another land who needs it. But so far, I haven't been able to find anyone." Well, without Bardas in it, it's just a normal sword, right? Or is it just... I guess it's still extraordinarily sharp or strong or something. Thomas says, "Well, continue looking. You'll find someone." "By the way, Professor Lapp, what does Elusian mean?" "It means Paradise of the Gods in the ancient language. It's not really appropriate now that the gods are gone." "You're right," Thomas says. "Then how about giving it a different name? A name that better suits the new era." "That's a good idea. A name that better suits the new era. How about Espelancer?" "Espelancer? That must be another ancient term." The word has a dignified tone to it. What does it mean?" "None of your business what it means. I'm gonna fade to black now." "Its meaning is to lay a path of hope." Okay. That's the end. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next... in the next Legend of Heroes game, Song of the Ocean, coming next. Other than that, I hope to see you guys in maybe another Let's Play besides the Legend of Heroes. There's plenty out there. You guys are all welcome. Thanks so much for watching and for going on this journey with me. And always, seek adventure.